Hi, I'm James Schillinglaw. I'm here with Jerish Jhunjhunwala, who is the founder and CEO of Ovalo Hotels, based in Hong Kong and Australia. We're not there right now. We're actually in the streets of New York, but we're going to find all about Ovalo Hotels, and this is Insider Travel Report. Now, Jerish, tell us about, when did you found Ovalo?
So Ovalo Hotels, so I started the brand Ovalo in 2002 right. As a service apartment, and it has one property. And in 2009, obviously after the financial crisis, I decided to change the model mm-hmm. and got into hotels and started the Ovalo Hotels. So 2010 was the first Ovalo Hotel.
Okay, and where was that located?
In Hong Kong Central.
Okay, yeah, I know that very well. Yes, in fact, absolutely. I was just there. And then you've expanded since then. Now, where have you gone?
So we have five properties in Hong Kong, all Ovalo, and now we've gone into Australia. We've got seven properties in Australia.
And and I understand you also have a couple of different brands too, right now?
Yeah, we just started a new brand called Mojo Nomad.
And what's the difference there?
Well, Mojo Nomad is looking at a different side of hotel business, which is going into the micro hotels.
Okay.
So kind of co-living micro hotels. So small rooms, very well appointed, very nice, very casual, and the main thing about it is there's a lot of communal spaces where people can go and hang around and so on. So if you don't want to be in your room, you can go downstairs.
A little noise from New York, there we go. Now, your original brand, tell me a little bit about that. How is it positioned?
Ovalo Hotels is, you know, it's everybody calls themselves a lifestyle brand. How do you define a lifestyle brand? And I think what the way we look at it is that we believe in a thing called effortless living. So where a guest customer doesn't have to think about anything. I mean, we have this all-inclusive package mm-hmm. where a guest can walk into their room and they don't have to worry about opening a mini bar and seeing what they consume and so on, because the mini bars are all included. Mm-hmm. We give them a little loot bag full of snacks and so on. All free, all complimentary of the house.
That's a little dangerous for me sometimes.
I know, well, we had to think about this twice when we went to Australia because of the minibar, but it worked out well. And then we have this free breakfast, all inclusive. And the best part about it, and what the guests really talk about is the social hour, yeah. Which is, you know, during 5 to 6 p.m. The guests can all come down, have a drink. The GM of the hotel is there. And you can meet other guests, talk about favorite night spots, restaurants you went to, and drinks are free. You can meet the GM, ask GM for the tips and so on. So this is probably one of the best things that we've done, where the GM hosts drinks for all the guests.
And what's the decor of the hotels?
It's fun, it's slightly edgy. We have a very big emphasis on art and music. And it's just a great vibe when you walk in. Every time I still walk into my hotels, it feels good.
Yeah. Now you have the hotels in Hong Kong. You have the hotels in Australia. Any plans to go elsewhere?
Oh, absolutely. We want to continue our growth in Australia, and we're starting to look at New Zealand. The thing what we're trying to do now is, you know, we've been buying single assets and turning them around. I like to look at a portfolio of hotels within Australia or New Zealand, or even now I'm looking out in US. Los Angeles, New York, great markets to be in.
Well, you and I can go scouting at hotels now down the block if you want to find a good spot, right?
Well, you never know.
We're outside. Well, it sounds like a great product. What should U.S. travel agents know about your properties, and how should they position them for their clients?
Oh, well, if you are coming down to Australia or Hong Kong, there's only one place to stay, Ovalo.
Very good. Well, Jerish, thank you very much
thank
for
you.
Filling us in on Ovalo Hotels. And I'm James Schillinglaw, and this is Insider Travel Report.